Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through read and write operations on associate memory. So let us first go through write operations. So when a word is written in an associate memory, we need not to specify any address or memory location, guys. So basically it stores at the places where there is no memory or it is free space, guys. So the memory is capable of finding its unused space. So let us assume that the addresses from 4 zeros to 1000 are already stored or already occupied. So initially with one with any kind of bits, that may be any combination other than 000. In that positions, the new values will be stored. If you add a new content, that can be stored in those memory locations. Okay guys, so now I hope everyone got a small idea. So now let us go through read operation. When a word is to be read from an associate memory, the content of the word or a part of a word is specified and it is matched, guys. So the memory locations, all the word which matches are specified by the content by reading one after the other, by reading the mark register, guys. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So in the previous tutorial, we have gone through associate mapping. If you missed that, please go back and watch it, guys, because it's really an important concept. Before reading this read and write operations, you need to know what is associate mapping. So I hope everyone is now 100% clear with this. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through cache memory. Thank you. Thanks for watching.